So the red side of the racket is the smooth rubber. For the player with the serve, Olga Kim. This is a best of seven match. And there's the start. With the pip side of the racket, generates less spin, especially early on in the rally. Side of the table. Oh, they gave it to her. I don't think Kim's going to accept that. She said no, that definitely went down, was the outside. See it again. Good sportsmanship here. Yeah, that didn't catch any of the top edge. And they're still discussing it. This is surprising. I wouldn't be surprised to see Olga Kim dump this point here. Oh. Maybe she wasn't sure it hit the side, but just wanted to check with her opponent. Either way, first 3 points to Olga Kim. For Netta to keep her focus here. Shah Savari seems right back in the match. Patient play to start. For Shah Savari, she could push the ball a lot and try to force the expedite rule. Long rallies to start. And that might be to her advantage if she feels that Kim is really not comfortable in the attacking game. But either way, it's been far from 13 returns. We see this a lot in table tennis. The ball comes up a little bit high from the chopper, and it seems like it's easy to flat hit through. But rarely is that the case. Patience and time settling in. It's going to be very important for Shah Savari. This time early on makes the aggressive shot to take the point. Only her second point this game. Step around, a huge shot inside out. Olga Kim showing versatility near the table. Again, all modern defenders need to be able to come in and attack. Quick to turn the corner and recognize the opportunity. For those of you just joining the tournament, you're watching this because both of these women are fighting for a chance to get a ticket to Rio. The winner of this match will qualify for the Olympics. Excellent soft touch, Shah Savari leaving it on the table. Again, the step around attack wide out to the forehand side. Now, normally the advantage is to the left-handed player, but if a left-handed player gets a little bit comfortable waiting on the backhand corner, leaves open the inside-out forehand for the righty. One game point saved by Shah Savari. Two in a row, a bit more consistency early on in the point. See, you're still warming up, getting into a rhythm out here. Power right into the body. The first time we've seen the shot into the body from Shah Savari. Deepest chop we've seen yet at the very baseline of the table. And game one goes to Olga Kim, 11 points to 7. We'll be back for game two after this short break. Back for game two. Shah Savari with the serve, down 0-1 in games. No! Soft touch and just mistimed by Shah Savari. Now again from Middle Asia or Central Asia, we have IR Iran, we have Uzbekistan and Kazakhstan. All fighting for a spot, but right here it's Uzbekistan. Uzbekistan's own Olga Kim in black who's leading. And Iran's Neda Shah Savari in green at the top of the screen. Again, a real trailblazer for Iran. First female table tennis player to represent in the Olympics for Iran. You really saw Shah Savari start to wake up in the end of game one after being way down in the start. Coming back to 7 points. First backhand attack I can recall from Shah Savari. But a wise shot selection. Had her opponent up near the table and had to take advantage. But a solid block on the forehand side from Olga Kim. Deceptive serve, long out to the forehand side. Looked like there might have been some topspin on it, but sure enough, more under than anything with the side. It's very important for the attacker to make sure they're moving their feet. That last ball seemed a little bit rushed by Shah Savari. What are you going to do against that? Pip side early on, a little bit of side spin into the body. Clever receive from Olga Kim. Flat hits aren't landing either. You can understand the frustration for Shah Savari. There we go, more steady, patient play. Decides to spin the ball early on. Not that one. Almost ran into the scorekeeper's booth. You could see she was frustrated with the space. This ball is as wide on the table and close to the net. Look at this, right into the middle. And then on the white of the line. One game point saved by Shah Savari. This is two games in a row that Shah Savari has made her campaign late. Started her comeback run. But it ends quickly, 11 points to 5. Olga Kim stepping into a 2-0 lead in this best of 7. We'll be back for game 3 to see if Shah Savari can turn things around just after this. We're back for game 3. Olga Kim with the serve, leading 2-0 over Iran's Neda Shah Savari. Strong start, patient play, spinning, forcing Kim to come back into the table, then catching her in and spinning her out. I think this is going to be key. Shah Savari really does need to play patiently. Flat hits are very difficult to land against heavy rotation. No, but she does it twice. A ripping backhand after an aggressive forehand. Two of the hardest shots we've seen yet from Shah Savari. Big one right there, a little on the body, and a fearless backhand while Kim comes running into the table. No chance with this follow-up. That was like the Zhuang Ziyuan backhand we saw earlier today. Shah Savari definitely didn't start the fire, but right now she's caught it. Hasn't lost a point yet in game 3. Working hard for every shot, focused with the touch shots, leaving it just low enough that Kim didn't have a big window of opportunity to make that attack. Well placed serve for Kim's first point this game. This time she makes it over the barriers. Very difficult receive to handle too. Ball with side spin bending into the body, but well placed right on the body. Earns a slap shot to put away. We saw Li Xiaoxia do this earlier. That's some satisfaction right there. The backhand again, it looked like she was going to drop it on the table. Gets in there quickly with a short stroke, just puts it away. These are the types of scores that Shaw Savari's been on the losing end of the first two games. How the table has turned. Only Kim's second point this game, but Shaw Savari needs to stay focused. Tactically, I think this is right. She's bringing the defender in and out. While early on in the match, Olga Kim was punishing with the attacks on the forehand side. Shaw Savari hasn't given her much chance to attack yet this game. Little off the back edge. Still a powerful shot. See this one more time. Spin shot gets the ball back just a little bit high. Difficult when the ball's in near the net. Of course, the angle's easier if it's high enough. But it's tough because the racket's so far away from the body. You don't get as much body support behind your shot. And a slap shot. Very irreverent backhand. This is the don't tell me what to do shot. Twiddles. So quick to twiddle the red to the backhand. And right back to the forehand to get into her game. But Shaw Savari has earned 5 game points here. After being dominated in the first two. Looking very good right now. And there it is, a quick escape, 11 points to 5. And the domination has turned right back around. Shaw Savari is making this a match. 1-2. We'll be back for game 4 after this short break. As the players come back for game 4, Olga Kim in black, the defender, just lost the last game 11 points to 5 after winning the first two 7-5. Those are going to come up from time to time, a little bit higher, deep on the table. Shaw Savari's been successful flat hitting through several of them, but has worked hard to earn more hittable balls by spinning softly on the first. And Kim is fired up every point. In case you're just tuning in so you understand why, this is to determine who will go to the Olympics representing their region of Middle Asia. Only one of these players will get a ticket to Rio here. The way Shaw Savari is playing now and as of the start of game 3, it's tough to tell who it's going to be. Fist pumped in the air, quick reaction to get around. Ball left too high, clearly. But still, that close to the net is tough for Kim to get in quickly. No! This time the backhand attack. Have to see that one again to see which side of the racket. If I were to guess, I would have said it was the pip side. Generally much easier to attack with the twiddle, as Kim has done before in this match. Absolute determination right there on the attacks of Shah Savari. Keeping her opponent far from the table, bringing her right back in. And while she's still near the table, waiting to see what sort of an attack she's going to get, this is Shah Savari breaking patterns, keeping herself unpredictable. That's the pattern she's been setting up, attack. Push back short, bring her in and out, which is why Kim on the point before was so surprised by two attacks in a row. The angle here from the left-handed player, hooking it deep to the backhand for the point. This match is getting better and better. From the start, it was a bit one-sided. But Neda Shah Savari really making a case out here to keep you on the edge of your seat. Look long to me from here. Those pips on the backhand. And again with the twiddles, most commonly how it is. Rare way to see a point one out here. Shah Savari with the serve to earn the outright point. Now, while a team can bring two players for singles, a national association that is, not every national association will get two players playing in singles. This stage one qualification could be the only chance for both of these players. Or at least the best chance before it comes down to world rankings. From a regional standpoint, it definitely is. These players aren't battling against China, Japan, Korea, Hong Kong, Chinese Taipei. Beautiful backhand from in near the table. Let's see one more time. The quick twiddle so fast, she turns the red to the backhand side to hit. And this time it doesn't come over the net. We've seen a few of those come down. One of them, Shah Savari won, and the other one, Kim had jammed her over near the scorekeeper's booth. Left just a little bit high, and Kim exploits the opportunity for the attack. First time we've seen some defense, not just pushing, but off the table play from Shah Savari here. Tries to go for the loop from out in front. One thing I'm thinking watching for Shah Savari, how clever she is about where she places her pushes. Sometimes they're soft when she senses that Kim is backing off the table. Other times they're deep pushes to make sure that she can't return or turn the corner and hit with her forehand. Like that, the inside out forehand. Ball left just a little bit high on the table. This is the defender keeping the attacker honest here. under pressure to make solid pushes and keep the ball low. And the lead has disintegrated. It's now 9-all, tied up at the third towel break. This could be the turning point in the match. Shaw Savari now on the receive. Both players 2 points away from taking the game. Well, that scream hit a whole new octave. The human ear can only hear so high. But I think that just goes to show you how much it means to Olga Kim to play in the Olympics. Game point. Huge point, 11-9 to go up 3-1 over Iran's Neda Shahsavari. We'll be back to see if it's the last game of the match or if the battle continues. Game 5 just after this. Now back for game 5, Olga Kim in black from Uzbekistan, leading 3-1 over Neda Shahsavari from Iran. The last two games have been especially exciting. Now if Olga Kim wins this game, she will not be playing tomorrow or for the rest of this tournament because she cannot qualify to play in stage 2. She'll already be on her way to Rio. Pummeled right down the middle of the table. Shahsavari has shown us that she's got the power. Quick to get in and take advantage of this higher ball. The ball wasn't that shallow on the table either, but it still makes a big difference, 6 inches in or back. Beautiful shot, misleading with the upper body and taking it out wide to the forehand side. Half long serve to the forehand side. Catcher Washley still backing up. It's tough to move side to side while you're moving back or forward. Clever idea. Saw Kim backing up, tried to play it softly, keep it on the table. Now the demeanor of these players could not be more opposite. I personally find it quite interesting. Not one better than the other necessarily. Between the focused player in green, Shahsavari. I mean, both players are clearly focused. Olga Kim, very vocal and expressive. And a cho from Shahsavari, still pale to comparison by volume. Clever idea, the wide serve to the forehand side, then hit it deep to the backhand. But Kim kept the chop low enough to deter that last attack. Wow. From right at the baseline of the table. Tough to tell exactly what she was going to do with that. Generating a lot of power in the last moment. Watch this one more time. It looked like she paused for a second, like she was considering pushing it back. Flat hitting forehand on the step around. Kim takes the point, but just barely. Shah Savari holds still, keeps her composure. It's very difficult to put the ball back on the table on a flat hit. Tough to block. Once again, back in at the table, the fast feet of the defender. Kim's percentages have gone, they've been outstanding so far in the attacking game this match. Straight back. Watch how she backs up for the shot. The racket head up so fast in that acceleration. The timeout has been called. Neda Shah Savari here in the corner with the coach. Had a chance to hit with their coach at the 2015 World Championships in Suzhou. A lot of friendly players in Iran. Fans watching right now in Iran. As well as in Uzbekistan. There's head coach from the Iranian national team on the left. So with just a few seconds left, Neda Shah Savari back at the table with a plan. We'll see how it works out. She's had trouble keeping Olga Kim off the attack recently. Game three, the one that Shah Savari won decisively, 11-5. There was a lot of in and out. Focused pushes, soft touch. There was a twiddle. You might have noticed it. It was the black side of the racket that came back. After a heavy push with the red side, the inverted rubber switched back, twiddled, and then the ball was overcompensated on the lift by Shah Savari. Hear the sound, just not as much spin on that last ball, trying to play a strong shot, a little bit flatter. It's starting to feel a little bit more like games one and two. Shah Savari hasn't found the rhythm since the timeout. But this time the backhand opening earns the high ball to come back for that forehand put away shot. Very confident opening backhand. Again, the backhand, different spin and trajectory than the forehand shot. But now 1 point away from a ticket to Rio, Olga Kim of Uzbekistan up 10-6, four championship points for Middle Asia. Wow, but not yet. Suitcase can't be packed too soon. Most important point, the toughest point in the match is match point. Kim still has to cross the finish line. Ouch, just smacking through it again. Very focused shots, a few in a row from Iran's Neda Shah Savari. Teammates in the crowd cheering her on. She started her comebacks against game points, but has yet to take a game in that situation. Only in game three where she dominated. Outstanding points. Shaw Savari saving the ball as it came floating back to the very edge of the table, deep into the backhand court. This is three championship points that Shaw Savari has saved and has one more serve to deuce it up here in game five. And she's done it, 10-10. Lives to see at least two more points. But the job is not done. This is a little bit of breathing room. But if she stops to take too much of a breath here, she could end up losing it. New ball has been introduced. After so many crushing shots from Shaw Savari. Pretty impressive that the ball has lasted as long as it did. So four in a row for Shaw Savari to take it to 10-10. Oh, and a break off the top of the net to earn game point. The crowd ooing, but the fans cheering as well. No matter which side you're rooting for, you want to see this match continue. Deuce in the seventh. That's where it's at. And she does it, six in a row. Iran's Neda Shaw Savari has quieted Olga Kim for at least this game. We're going to see a sixth game, and who knows? It's getting exciting. Stick around. Game six just after this. Price pushes low enough. Kim not having the easy attack. Could today be the day for Shaw Savari? Kim is going to do everything she can to secure this ticket. Really, it's just mind-numbing watching these twiddles, how fast Olga Kim spins the racket in her hand to switch sides and surfaces. This is something that takes years and years and years of practice. A little bit late to get in for it. Timing, if you can't keep it low, but the player is far from the table, it buys you a little bit more time, a little bit more margin for error on your touch game. And the inside out forehand, left-handed specialty served up for dinner here on the table. Look at this one more time. Deep into the middle, little bit of side spin on it, and it's bending out of reach. Shaw Savari back on fire. It's a bit surprising after all that focus play in some of these long rallies. Been a very rare occasion. I can't recall Shaw Savari blocking the ball back into play when Kim is attacked with the forehand. It ends the point. Either way, for one of the players, either Kim misses or she makes it and it ends the point. Shaw Savari clearly not happy with the bounce there, deep on the table. Spin variation can be responsible for that, not necessarily particles of anything on the table. Little softer shots, spinning it up. Shaw Savari stepping back into the lead. This is 2 points in a row that Shaw Savari's taken her time. Put a little extra spin on the ball instead of going for power. This is, again, breaking the rhythm that she set up. She's gotten Olga Kim used to being far from the table in these attacks with a lot of speed and power. Now changing it up, bringing her in, spinny shots. feel for Shaw Savari. You have to cringe a little bit. The ball coming up high, the step around. But she's a professional, focused, ready for the next point. You could see the positive head shake. From this angle, you could see how deep on the table it was, though. Not an easy shot. What I like there about Shaw Savari's touch, she didn't show she was going for the push until the last moment. If you telegraph too much, make it clear what you're going to do. The opponent has time to get ready, come back into the table, be there for the attack. Heavy spin again. And the spin has been overwhelming Kim. This is about the third that I can recall this game. Spinny shot that's come back long off of Kim's backhand. Earning the high ball for the inside out forehand. Shaw Savari on the road to game seven. Still 2 points to go. And 1 point away from going to game seven. We've got 5 game points for Neda Shaw Savari. And the first time I've seen it, the forehand is blocked back into play, and it's for game point, 11 points to 5. Neda Shaw Savari is making this a 7-game extravaganza. The decider coming back after this short break. Side of the table, I guess it was Olga Kim's chop that came back. We've got vocality on both sides. Shaw Savari pumped up. Fine balance, has to keep her focus on every shot. Huge shots right into the neck, straight to the jugular. Recovering a netball early in this rally, was just talking about the focus factor. Look at this. Way wide. Plays the angle and a beautiful chop comes all the way back. What are you going to do about that one? Just turns her head. And a quick invisible point there. Olga Kim earning it. almost comes back. Shah Savari demonstrating the power again when she earns that higher ball. It's the spinny first one. Investment in the next attack. Shot selection combined with patience. The first shot a little more patient and spinny, but earning the attack. Shah Savari looks so much quicker on her feet, her racket speed. And they're going to switch sides, but there's a timeout. Olga Kim calls the timeout as they switch sides. And we've seen both players sitting down on timeouts before. It's my first time seeing Olga Kim. And watching the coach. Seems very delicate, very well thought out. But maybe searching for answers. Olga Kim, when she spins with the forehand, has been effective. Only at game point in game six has it been returned. But I think a big part of that is she's earned her opportunities for higher put-away shots. She's not spinning from down low or starting rallies. She's finishing them with that shot. So Neda Shah Savari, the first one back at the table. Don't always have to use all the time you have. Just a word or two from the coach when you're on a roll. Maybe don't change a thing. But for Olga Kim, there are going to be some changes out here. We'll see how the tactics change. Outstanding play right out of the timeout. Quality chops from all over the court. Olga Kim showing her fancy footwork out here. How quickly she comes back into the table. From the back edge to deep in the forehand. All over. Oh, the break off the edge. In case the twiddle wasn't enough to hang with in the middle of that rally. Bit of fortune here, quick apology. It's all part of the game, the head nod there, keeping the positive energy. Short side of the table, the fast, powerful attack. Shah Savari breaking the streak. Was up 5-2 at the switch. Had this point gone the other way, it would have been tied at 5-all, 3 in a row for Kim. But instead, Shah Savari with the lead and two serves. It's been a while since we've seen that happen. Heavy chop loaded there. Shah Savari a bit fooled, drops it into the bottom of the net. Uzbekistan players in the crowd supporting their player. The first one was a tough chop from off balance. Looked like she was on one foot when she got it back, but coming rushing back into the table. This again is Shah Savari recognizing an opportunity to drop. Chole Iran from the crowd. Perfectly placed serve. Looks like it's going to bounce twice on the table. Shah Savari going aggressively, ambitiously trying to attack that ball. But definitely not playing afraid. Still a one-point lead for Shah Savari. But the heavy chop, and it's tied up at 7-all. 7-7 in the seventh. Doesn't get much closer than this. Thank you. and starting to unravel a little bit. Shaw Savari has been so tight with all of her shots, from the pushes to the attacks, patient play, the opening spin shot. Deep on the table again. It looked like it might have come off the table. Shaw Savari seemed a little bit surprised herself. And what a streak. Olga Kim, 2 points in the lead, but has not been vocal in her celebration, has been keeping it all in as she needs to stay focused here. It's interesting to see when a player internalizes their excitement, how it affects their confidence. Outstanding point, Brooks. Two forehand loops back into play. Comes running back into the table. This is the first time we've seen Shaw Savari sacrifice so much space on the table. Has to jump to get that one back. Look at this, and then the push. Shallow and spins it hard deep into the backhand side. The crowd leaning forward up against the rails here. You could hear the mumbles getting louder and louder. And we are tied up at 9 points each. Shaw Savari with the last two serves this match, we'll see. Power, and it's match point, championship point, Rio de Janeiro ticket point for Iran's Neda Shaw Savari. Olga Kim under pressure, trying to stay cool out here. Came all the way back, lost the last 3 points in a row. Oh, and an edge again! Two edges in the middle of the points, a recovery off the net. This had everything, and you've got to laugh about that. The crowd absolutely loving what they've seen out here. This is as intense as the championship point gets, the very faintest part of the edge. And here we are, folks, deuce in game seven. No place I'd rather be. Inside out forehand for the point, finishing it early. Neda Shaw Savari back in Rio ticket seat. Again, match point, the toughest point of the match. The last match point we saw. Just insanity out here. And there it is, Neda Shaw Savari takes it home for Iran, and a huge hug with the coach in the corner. Neda Shaw Savari writing history for Iran. Two times in the Olympics, the first woman to go to the Olympics representing Iran in table tennis will also do it again in 2016. Congratulations to the Iranian left-handed attacker, and it all pays off. A rough start, but she sweats and muscles it through, and the flag proudly on the back of Neda Shaw Savari, world ranked number 294, for the first time ever, has taken down Uzbekistan's Olga Kim. And what a battle from both players. Respect all around in the arena, absolutely loving this match. A tough day for Olga Kim, but a proud moment for all of Iran, led by Neda Shaw Savari here today. Are we gonna see a victory lap with the flag? A little bit of paperwork here, a review of the scores, and look at how close they got. The flag is being run around the court, and another huge hug and celebration for the Iranian team. Once again, congratulations, Neda Shaw Savari. This is only the first of four televised finals today. We've got another one coming up shortly between Li Ping and Abdulaziz Al Abad from Saudi Arabia. Stick around and enjoy the highlights in the meantime.